This is my capstone assignment, and I'm Justin Larson. Alright, so I first picked to describe three areas of improvement and how you realize each need. So I picked poor organization skills, not studying, and opening up to my teachers and classmates. My first one, my time in general studies, I realized I am not an organized guy, and it really sucked. I learned that being organized, it really messed me up because, I would always lose assignments. Lose assignments was, my worst thing I had. I always would have, assignment, and then also I would think I wouldn't need to keep assignments, so I'd throw assignments away, and I learned that I needed to organize my assignments in each class so I had all my paperwork and stuff. Studying for classes was hard for me in the start of the quarter, but once I noticed that if I didn't study, my test scores went down. That really sucked, and I learned I needed to start studying because I've never been the guy to study. In high school, I always, if I found out I had a test, I would kind of, glance at the papers real fast and hope for the best. But in college, it really messes up your grade. Talking to teachers and classmates was pretty scary for me. But I saw other students getting help from teachers, and I realized I probably should start asking teachers for help. I'm still not great on getting help from teachers, but that's because I'm not a shy guy. I like talking to people. It's just when it comes down to asking a question for my help, I've always been the person that gets scared. I don't know why, I just if you like fishing or something, I'll talk to you for all day if I don't know you. But just to ask someone a question to help me, I get nervous. Even I have buddies that are chiropractors and I have a messed up back. They always ask me to go in and get help, but I'm one of those guys, I just can't ask for the help. I don't know why. But I'm hoping to start asking teachers for help because I feel because a lot of times I'm sitting at home and I don't know how to do an assignment, and I feel like I probably should email a teacher, but I'm scared because I'm what if I don't understand what he's saying and then I have to email him again, and I just get scared, so I just don't email. So
describe three school-related challenges you were nervous about this quarter but you overcame. So my fear of people watching me,
I don't know, I just have I've always had a thing where I get scared if I think someone's talking about me. This makes me have a weird feeling.
Not using school resources, that's a big thing. I really, really, really am glad I'm using school resources now because it's been helping me a lot. Thinking I wasn't smart enough for college. So I was so nervous to go to Fast Fitness. Took me 4 weeks to go for the first time because I was scared to work out with other people. I have a fear of being around people. I don't know how I overcame my. I don't know why, but I overcame my fear because in class one day I told Mr. Cameron. That I haven't gone to Fast Fitness yet. And then Mr. Cameron asked me why I was in college and kind of was like, I want to go to school. Didn't really give him a good answer. And then once I still didn't go to Fast Fitness that whole week, and I kind of realized if I don't have my grades, I can't really do anything with as a future because I'm getting this opportunity to go to school right now, and if I fail, then I have to pay with my own money to go to school. So I kind of just realized I need to go to Fast Fitness, but I was just really scared that people were going to I don't know, I don't go to the Y because there's too many people work out there, and it kind of freaks me out that they're going to that guy can't lift weights. I don't know, I just don't like it. For the first couple weeks, I was scared to use school resources. I would study at home, but I found out my house and my girlfriend's house was not a good work area for me. Too much distractions, computers, noisy kids. But then we went to the in class. We went to the library tour, and I saw that the library was like a super quiet place and had like a bunch of computers. And so I started going to the library because really quiet, and I always get work done because once I start, I just finish it, and I like the library a lot. I haven't really went anywhere else in like labs or anything, but I know those resources are here, so I might use them in the future. I was nervous to be in college because I'm not the brightest squirrel in the tree. I have struggled in high school, which made me super nervous for college. I knew college was going to be hard, but I didn't think I was going to have to study and do as much homework. I was kind of hoping just to wing by, because that's what I usually plan on doing, is just wing it. But I realized you can't do that.
Alright, so describe three skills you learned about and how you can continue to practice them. So, schedule planning, eating on a budget, and note-taking skills.
Alright, so don't make a schedule, plan, or study homework. You can really fail easily. I will always be making a schedule and become more organized for the rest of my life now. I kind of realize like if I don't have a schedule for school and stuff, it's kind of hard for me to like get stuff done. In my whole life, my whole family is not a scheduled people. We kind of just wake up and go with the flow. Never really ever make plans. Like if we're gonna go on a trip, it's gonna be last minute. It's gonna be like the day before we're gonna go on a trip. So it's kind of hard for me to make a schedule because my whole life we just have not like made a schedule. We eat lunch, dinner, whatever. Like when it happens. So going to school and doing homework was a big thing because I like fishing, hang out with my friends a lot. So it's kind of now I kind of learned how to like slow down and start doing homework and stuff. So I'm hopefully next quarter, this summer, I'm gonna improve and like study a lot. I know it's gonna be hard because the weather and it's gonna be nice out, but I'm gonna try hard and do school. So note taking, I really like the note taking because I've never really took good notes. I kind of just write random stuff on paper and then kind of just have to find where my stuff is, and that's always been hard. I really like the Cornell notes that we learned in class. That Cornell notes is pretty easy and I kind of like how it functions. I think note taking is gonna be awesome because like in my job field I wanna do eventually, I wanna be a fish biologist, so a lot of note taking skills on stream surveys and fish surveys. So note taking is definitely gonna be something I'm tackling for the rest of my life.
Fishing
is not just something I like to do. Like, it just means a lot to me. When I was younger, my family got a divorce. My parents got a divorce when I was younger, and when I was about 9. And it just, my childhood was like, I was just really sad all the time. And fishing was the thing that like got me happy. Being outside and just like, this is a place to think. It's like a nice area just to like, just be you. And I've always used it, and now it's like a thing in my life. I have to do it all the time because I feel really peaceful and it makes me happy.
So I kind of wrote a saying. It just stuck with me since I was little.
So when I was younger, this old guy, I caught my first summer on sea lion, and it was pretty funny. This old guy just comes up to me and says,
boy, you didn't catch that steelhead. That steelhead caught you. And ever since he said that, it stuck to me because it really, really honest truth. After that day, it was always happening. So, yeah, I didn't bring any mementos. Fishing is my memento. Like, I don't really have something that I hold on to. And my rods are too expensive to bring to school. And that's that.
All right.
What's your favorite places to go fishing around here?
Around here, I go up to the coast a lot, so I like fishing out in the forest and along the coast, on the rivers. But like locally, if I'm gonna like fish around, I fish the Sound a lot for like sea run cutthroat, fish the lakes and stuff. And but in another couple of weeks, all the salt water is about to be popping.
Right now is
getting degrees.